Let us take a few complicated questions on linear sitting arrangements. In this case, he says A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H are 8 students of a school. They study in standard 6th, 7th and 8th without more than 3 in any standard. So we have standard 6, then we have standard 7 and we have standard 8. This we can write here. Each of them have a favorite subject from physics, geography, English, Marathi, mathematics, chemistry, biology and economics, but not necessarily in the same order. So basically what I see is that these English, Marathi, these subjects have to be allocated to these students and these students are also to be hooked to these sections. This is going to be possibly the theme of this question. D likes chemistry and then there are certain statements. So let us first of all build it first and then we'll proceed with them. We'll go by writing these subjects first. So let us write physics. Then we have to write geography. I'll put a line here to separate them. Geography. Then I have to put English. Then Marathi. Then maths, then chemistry, then biology, and then economics. So I have these subjects and these are the sections and these are the students which have to be allocated. He says D likes chemistry and studies in standard 8 with only H. Now about these standards, he has already given that more than 3 cannot study in one standard. So D likes chemistry. This is a very concrete fact. So let us put D here with chemistry. Studies in standard 8th. So D studying in standard 8th. So we'll write D here. And he studies with H only. So this means this standard is going to have D and H only. B does not study in standard 7. So if B doesn't study in standard 7 and in standard 8 only 2 are there, so in standard 6 we must have B. E and A study in the same standard but not with B. E and A are not in 6th, not in 8th, so they should be in standard 7. Okay. C and F study in the same standard. C and F study in the same standard. Now, we have to allocate C and F, but C and F cannot fit this one because it will make 4. It can't come here because 2 only are here, so C and F should come here. So with this, I think A, B, C, D, E, F, G, one of them is left and that is certainly going to come here. So all the persons have been fitted into the standards now. One part of our job is almost over. Those who study in standard 6th do not like maths or biology. So B, C and F, they are in standard 6th, they don't like biology. So what I'll do is, I'll write here B cross, C cross, F cross. This means these can't come into this one. Those who study in standard 6 do not like mathematics or biology. They are not going to like maths also. So I'll cross here B cross, C cross and F cross. Then he says F likes physics. Now this is a very concrete thing that is given to us. So we'll straightway put F here with physics. The one who studies in standard 8th likes English. In standard 8th, we have D and H. D is already allocated to chemistry. So this means H, it should go to English. So we'll put with English H here. So H comes here. C does not like geography. So we'll find geo and cross it here. C can't come here. A's favorite subject is Marathi. Marathi is here and we'll put A here. And G does not like biology, so we will put a cross here with G. G doesn't like biology. What is the arrangement? Now, as our pass, first pass completes, this is the scene that we have right now. Let us now move to our second pass. We can now examine this one. Basically, geographies need to be allocated, maths and economics. These three need an allocation. C can't come here, C can't come here, and C can't come here also in bio also. So C can come in economics, so I'll write C. So C is allocated. Because there is a bar on C coming here, bar on C coming here, in fact it's already filled also. Bar on C coming here, so the remaining place for C is this one. So C is also allocated and economics is also allocated. Now let us see what can come in bio, maths and geography. In case of this maths, let us now see it critically. In case of bio, we know that B can't come, C can't come, F can't come and G can't come. Now there is probably going to be one person who will ultimately come. Let us check it out who it is. A has already been fitted, B can't come here, C is already adjusted, D is already adjusted, E is left and F can't come. So E will be the one who can fit here. Now it is the turn of fitting geography and maths. At present, who is left? One B is left and other G is left. We have to now allocate these two places and that will finish our job. Now how do we go about it? Here he says G, wait a minute. Those who study in standard 6 do not like maths or biology. Standard 6 B and B needs to be fitted. So maths won't come, B won't come in maths because this B doesn't like maths or bio. So B can't come here. Obviously G will come here and the remaining space will be filled by B. So this is the sitting arrangement that is possible in this case. This is how we can work on these by just ruling out the possibilities that can't exist and fitting in as much information as is available concretely to us, as we have done in this case. Let us take another example to understand these concepts of complicated sitting arrangements. This question says, 5 plays A, B, C, D and E were organized in a week from Monday to Saturday with one play on each day and no play was organized on one of these days. There are 5 plays and days are 6, so one of these days must have been a holiday. Let us first of all write the days of the week here. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. These are the days available with us and probably I think these A, B, C, D, E will have to be allocated to these. Let us read the statement thoroughly. No play was organized on one of these days, so one of the days was no play day. We'll see it as we go. Play D was organized before Thursday but after Monday. So this means D was organized either, have I left something? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So D was organized either on Tuesday or Wednesday, after Monday and before Thursday. Then he says, play E was organized on Saturday. So E is already fitted. So I'll do one thing. The ones that are fitted, I'll write on the left side. So E is fitted perfectly. Play C was not organized on the first day. C didn't come here, so we'll write a cross here. So C is either on Thursday or Friday, we'll keep that in mind. Play B was organized on the next day on which play C was organized. So it means C can't come here, we already know. C can't come here because E is already filled. C can't come on Friday because after C, B was organized. So obviously C will come on Thursday and B was on the next day. So B will come here and C will come here. So two of them have been fitted. So this is how we are proceeding right now. Play B was organized on the next day on which play C was organized. So this fits that one. Play A was organized on Tuesday. So this is also very concretely given. So A is coming here. And obviously D, since has to be on Tuesday or Wednesday, D will fall on Wednesday. Now which one is left? A, B, C, D and E. So Monday is the no play day on which no play was organized. So this is how we can solve such questions. This one was relatively simple, and probably because the technique is helping us. So this is how we can tackle such questions. Let us take another example of these types of the complicated arrangements. Let us proceed to our next example.